Hello class, now in this lecture we will see another device to control a NOx emission. So here we suppose to go for the third device which controls a NOx emission. The first we have seen, that is reduction bed in case of the three-way catalytic converter. Second one is a storage catalytic converter, and this is a third one, that is selective catalytic reduction, or we can say it is a SCR technology. Okay, the Bosch calling it as a Dextron technology. Some other company are calling it as an AdBlue technology. Okay, so here we will see this technology, how it works exactly. So here this is an engine you're supposed to consider, and all the exhaust gases which is and coming from the exhaust manifold are guided to the turbocharger, and after the turbocharger is it reaches to pass the particular matter filter. Okay, so on that basis we supposed to or you come to know this is a diesel engine. So basically in case of the diesel engine, SCR is compulsory under the BS6 vehicle. So all the commercial trucks, you if you notice, there is a one DEF tank is additionally present. Normally a coolant tank is there, DF petrol tank is there, air tank is there, and in addition to that DF tank is also there in case of the commercial vehicle. You must notice this thing. So it is compulsory to have a SCR technology on commercial diesel vehicles. Okay, so all the exhaust gases is coming from the exhaust manifold are passed through the particulate matter filter, and after that it entering to the SCR technology, okay, or SCR device. So SCR device mainly consists of first of all DF tank, DF injection system, okay, and after that a SCR catalyst shell. Okay, so inside the SCR catalyst shell we have a catalyst substrate coated by a vanadium molybdenum or titanium or tungsten metal. Okay, so as we have seen the honeycomb substrate in the three-way and two-way catalytic converter, similarly inside this shell we have a substrate which is coated by a metal like vanadium or molybdenum or titanium or tungsten, which plays a role of catalyst in the reactions. Okay, and in front of this catalyst shell or SCR catalyst shell, the DF injection systems are present. DF injection, DF is nothing but a diesel exhaust fluid, or it also called as a AdBlue, or in simple word if you say it is nothing but the urea and water. It is a mixture of urea and water. In this tank we have a urea and water in order to form a diesel exhaust fluid. And this diesel exhaust fluid are supposed to be injected at this location with the help of injector. But metering is very precisely the metering of the DF into the stream, exhaust stream. This stream should have a temperature up to 630 degrees Celsius to 720 degrees. So that temperature need to be have to convert NOx into harmful component, that is nitrogen. So temperature is important over here. So here that nozzle present over here which metering a amount of DF injected, or you can say urea plus water injected into the stream, and it depends on the richness and leanness of exhaust gases, or richness or leanness of air fuel ratio metered by fuel injection system. So that integration, information sharing of fuel injection system with DF injection system need to be done over here. Okay, so as soon as this DF is injected into this hot exhaust stream, it get converted into ammonia and carbon dioxide. Now this ammonia plays a very important role, as carbon dioxide will not have a further oxidation. It get what we can say escape out through this system, but whatever the ammonia present over here, it plays a very important role. This ammonia entering to this SCR catalyst shell, and in addition in presence of this shell there is an NOx also present, so it takes those reaction, whatever the NO, NO2 are present, or whatever the NO3 is present. Right now I have not shown the NO3 reaction, but whatever the NO and NO2 present, similarly in case of the NO3 also it take place, but all the NO, NO2 and NO3 will react with the NH3 in the presence of catalyst like vanadium, tungsten or molybdenum material, okay, metal, in presence of temperature up to 200 to 450 degrees Celsius, and convert that NO, NO or NO2 or NO3 into nitrogen and water. Okay, so there are three possible reaction may take place inside that catalyst. So this is a thing how SCR working. So all as a fuel injection system meter a fuel quantity in order to acquire a required air fuel ratio, this system also working along with sharing information from the FI system to inject a DF into the exhaust stream. Because as richness is increases, definitely the chances of NOx generation will reduce. But as leanness increases, the chances of NOx formation will increases. Means when the fuel sended inside the combustion chamber is reached, that time temperature of combustion chamber is pulled down, because extra fuel quantity required heat to burn. So it get absorbed heat from combustion chamber and make combustion chamber cooler. But when fuel quantity or air fuel ratios forwarded into the combustion chamber is lean, that time there is no fuel present inside the combustion chamber to absorb the heat from their surface. So there is a chances of high temperature formation at the lean mixture, and at that time the quantity of DEF injected inside exhaust system here, okay, will be work along with the signal forwarded by the FI system. So whenever leanness is there, DEF forwarded into the stream will be more, and whenever richness is there, the quantity of DEF is injected into the stream will be low. And another thing need to be noticed here, this DEF tank we have to refill as we are filling our fuel tank, as we are filling our coolant tank. Okay, so this is a we can say consumable kind of technology in which we have to consuming a DEF. So it is the extra additional cost we are adding in addition to fuel quantity. Okay, so DEF, but the amount of DEF utilized is not as greater as we are fuel using. It required very less, okay, because not only we are using a SCR catalyst, we are also using a three-way catalyst also. So these are the technology which now mandatory in case of the BS6 commercial trucks. So every trucks have this SCR technology. It's called as a selective catalyst reduction system. Okay, so I hope you have understood this technology, that is SCR technology. If you feel any difficulty, please do comment in our comment section. Thank you.